The Greek is alive.
Oh, praise God.
Because of him, my daughter lives. He didn't have to save her. He sent me to a place for supplies. It was full of your people hiding out. He knew I could report them, have them all thrown into the circus today. I am grateful. My wife, my daughter are grateful.
I only hope it has shown you something true.
I am sorry for Nero's circus. I am sorry your people died today.
Have you ever been sailing?
Yes.
Imagine yourself looking out at the vast sea before you. You reach down and you put a hand into the water and you scoop it up towards you. Immediately the water starts leaking through your fingers until the hand is empty. That water is a man's life. From birth to death, it is always slipping through our hands until it is gone. Along with all that you hold dear in this world. And yet the kingdom I speak of, that I live for, is like the rest of the water out in the sea. Man lives for that cup of water that slips through his fingers. But those that follow Jesus Christ live for that endless expanse of sea.
What if, after all this, I still do not believe in your Christ?
I wasn't trying to convince you. Listen to me. There's only a moment. It's not me. It is Christ himself that looks upon you and shatters your defenses. And in that moment, you will understand that you are completely known by God. And you are completely loved. I will pray that moment comes for you. I think I would like a walk to enjoy this sun.
Of course.
You saved his daughter. They will know us by our love. This is the way.
I heard the cheers of the crowd from the Roan's house. I shall not forget their faces for as long as I live.
The trumpets would have sounded loudest when they arrived home.
A mighty celebration was held today.
A mighty celebration. If we live,